abilities that result in a calm, well-balanced mind and self-control. Over the week, I have an opportunity to speak to my old friend. I'm going to start from there. And we were those days in Christ Life Church in Ibadan, we used to be in choir. So me and I were talking, we're trying to go back to the memory lane of what life used to be. And she was saying to me, Samuel, those times, there were nothing really that speaks of a good future for us. The only thing we have was the church. We were there in the morning, in the afternoon, night vigils upon night vigils. She was born, and then the father and the mother dumped her to her granny, and then she was raised by her grandmother. And she said to me, Samuel, do you remember that I only have one skirt? I said, I remember, Remy, I remember. It was only one black skirt, because then our uniform used to be black. But thank God now, she said to me, thank God now, Samuel. She works now in Bank PHB as a senior accountant, married with 3 kids. Happily married, she's doing wonderful. So we were just recounting the goodness of God. And that's why I said to you when I started, I am not proud, I am grateful. And he said to me, he said, Samuel, I saw your picture on Facebook, and I said, hey, this is my Samu. You know, and she said, I remember those days where we come in the night for night vigils and we would just cry for God to help us. We didn't have admission. He said, Sammy, do you remember that I failed WAEC more than 7 times? I said, I remember. Praise God. The Lord is saying to somebody this morning, you are going to the next level. And because you are going to the next level, you need to face the fear face to face. God is speaking to someone in this place, especially to the people that are graduating. You're going to a world of so many uncertainty, so many things. I was saying to the president of United States, very soon we'll be saying to the president of United States. I was saying to the president of Nigerian society, I said, what happened in Greece is a maniac that nobody can put a point onto. I said to him, naturally, when you are driving on M1 and there's hold up and you see trailer by you, you will not go and run and park, will you? Because something tells you that the trailer behind you has a brake. Are you listening to me? So we are faced in the world that we have fear as a subject and what the devil is using. But I want to say to you this morning that fear is not from God. It's from Satan. Anytime you are afraid of something, I want you to know that it's not God. Humility is not being afraid. Fear is not from God. Anytime you are afraid, is a manifestation of the kingdom of darkness to keep you from fulfilling your destiny. One of the greatest secrets of the devil nowadays is using the spirit of fear. The question I want to ask you this morning is, what are you afraid of? What are you afraid of? Many of us are afraid of many things. Even many of us are afraid that we are not afraid. Amen to Jesus. I preached one time, long time ago, and I said, many of us, because we are so much worry machine, we worry that we are not worrying. But God said to, I should tell you this morning, that he has not given you the spirit of fear. He has given you, look at that word, the spirit. So anytime you are afraid, know that there is a spirit at work. There is a spirit at work. There is a spirit at work. When I was preparing, I come across a phrase called take inventory of your fear department. What are you afraid of? Are you afraid of what the future is going to hold? Are you afraid of, I am not going to get a job? Are you afraid of, how will this family end? Are you afraid of what is going to happen if the supply that you are having now stop coming? What are you afraid of? What are you afraid of? 1 John 14:8 says, there is no fear in love, but perfect love casts out fear, because fear has torment. That's where I'm going. Fear has torment. When you see people that are afraid, the first thing that you notice is they are naturally under torment of the enemy. Maybe that's why, according to the research on the Bible scholar, they said there is everyone fear not in the Bible for the whole 365 days of the year. Why is God saying to us, fear not? Because God is in heaven. We are on earth. So because we are surrounded with the limitation of human and what we can see, it is natural to want to be afraid. It is natural for you to be fearful, especially when you want to go for an interview. It is natural for you to be afraid when you want to submit your thesis. But the question I have for you this morning is that you need to step out in spite of fear. You need to step out in spite of fear. Learn to fear the fear of not stepping out. Never allow fear to incapacitate you into a level that you are not stepping out. Look at your neighbor and say, step out. Psalmist says in Psalm 56 verse 3, said, when the time I am afraid, I will trust in you. Don't allow fear to, you see, one thing I found out, you know the word there, torment, is also the word that means you're bound. One thing I found out is that maybe it doesn't happen to you. When you're afraid, you have less movement. It's as if your muscles are weakened. But I want to say to you that the future that God has for you is brilliant. The destiny that God has for you is brilliant. And you have to attack fear at its forehead and say to yourself, I have only one life and I'm going to make the best out of it. Can I get a amen to that? I have only one life, and I'm going to make the best out of it. I said, yeah, how does fear normally work? Some of us, we have different kind of fear. Fear of death. One time like that, Sam Adeyemi said, he was in class, and people were saying, because they have in the school then, one of the young, I don't know if it's happened to you before, but it has happened to me then when we're in Lautec. You just lose one of your class members. Has it happened to you before? And then you can't believe that person is just gone. You see, young people don't think of death. We don't. We only think of death when someone that is very close of the same age die, and we begin to say, oh my God, and you see, and everybody was just afraid. As Amadeemi said, he entered the room and they were saying, you see, this life is very small. Anybody can die at any time. And he said, no, I will not die at any time. You're not reading your Bible. And they said to him, "Sir, shut up your mouth, you this proud Christian." He said, "No, I'm not a proud Christian. Listen, I am not dying at any time." You did not read your Bible. The Bible says, Jacob called all his children, and after he has blessed them, then he slept. So that is the way we are going to go. Some people have fear of loneliness. Fear of people. Loneliness is one of the greatest things that makes people to be fearful. I'm all by myself. Some people have fear of even taking steps. Anytime you want to take a definite step to direction, to purpose, there's this thing that comes, that grips you, that stops you. I want to say to you this morning, it is a spirit and you need to deal with it. Because one thing that you should know is that nobody is going to give you your future unless you take it by yourself. Courage is acting in spite of fear. That's what courage is. Courage is not acting in the absence of fear. It is acting at the face of fear. That's what makes a courageous person. That's what makes a courageous person. The Bible says in Numbers, God spoke to Moses, said, "Gather the elders and let them go and spy the land." The first thing God is going to do to you, and I know God has been doing in this house, is that God is going to give you a witness or a glimpse of where he's taking you to. He's going to give you through his word. He's going to give it through revelation. He's going to give it through prophecy. And if he discovers that you are not hearing all those means, then he will now give you through dreams and revelation. Are you listening to me, house? God said to Moses, he said, "Go and spy the land for a witness." That's what he told them, for a witness. I thank God because God will never leave you without a witness. One of the things that God has used to deliver me from fear is that word witness. Anytime I'm in a situation, and I want to teach you this. Anytime I'm in a crossroad and I need to make a step, the first thing I ask God for is a witness. The scripture says, "Eyes has not seen, nor the ears have heard, what the Lord has in store for them that love the Lord. But it has been revealed by his spirit." Why did God send a witness? God sent a witness because God knew they are going to be meeting giants. So what God normally does, and for many of you that you are graduating, is that God normally gives commercial of your future for you. The reason why he's giving you commercial is that so that you can wait, pray, fast, so that you can get yourself from where you are to where you are going. Are you listening to me? But the Bible says when they got to the land, the Bible says they saw giants. Listen, for you that you are graduating, you're going to see giants. People that have experience more than you. People that have been in the field 100 years more than you. But listen to me, there is a mark of excellency on your head. I remember when Brother Kene came. He said, "Pastor, you don't understand. Everything I'm doing is just as if... Listen, it is not you. It is God that works in you." Are you listening to me? So never put the limitation of your capacity on your experience. Because the capacity of God inside of you is God himself. Don't put the capacity of what you want to do by experience. No. CV does not dictate all you know. CV is only an access for them to call you for an interview. Are you listening to me? CV cannot give the whole summary of the 5 years you learned in engineering. But that creative mind is when you come under the influence of the Holy Spirit. And the Bible says, what did they say? The people that went to the land, they said, this land is full of the children of giants. We can't do it. This land devour his own people. It's not the same land that you say was filled with milk and honey. I feel that was a contract of information. You carry grape in your hand and you say the land is devouring people. And watch this, I'm talking about facing fear. And when they came back to Moses, they said to Moses, this is our report. And God said, this is what scared me. I want you to listen to this. God said, as these people have said to me, so I will do. Even, listen, if you don't change the way you speak and you don't change your fear level, even God himself will be incapacitated to help you. God said, I cannot help them anymore. See, when I was reading that numbers, I shocked to my bone. God could have said, don't worry, that is their own opinion. Are you listening to me? God should have said that. God could have said, Moses, don't worry, you know, I told you guys, I'm going to take you to the land. But God said, as they have said to me, I will do. I was caught to my bone. See, when you don't change the way you talk, what you say about where you are going, even God himself will be incapacitated to help you. But Joshua said, he said, we are strong and able. We can take the land. We can take the land. Face your fear and move forward. Isaiah 41 verse 10 says, fear not, I am with you. You need to face the fear and move forward. What limitation are you putting on yourself? How do I face the fear and move forward? As a roundup. Number one, Isaiah 41 verse 10 that we read said, I am with you. God is with you. I don't know how I'm going to stress that so that you understand it. I'm not saying that as a statement of I'm a pastor. What that means is that I love the word, many of you that are close to me, I love the word capacity. The reason why I love the word capacity so much is because what God wants to do in my life is too big than this slim guy. So because of that, I learn to leverage on the capacity I can get from God. God said, I am with you. I'm with you. If God is by your side, you can take nations, sir. You can take nations. The master that was with Elijah said, Elijah, look, the armies are coming towards us. They are coming to kill us. And God, and if you look at, he didn't argue with him. He just said, God, open his eyes that you can see that those that are with us, hallelujah to Jesus, the capacity of who is with me, I'm not afraid, sir. I'm not afraid, sir. Do you know why I'm not afraid? Because I know where I'm coming from. Another thing, another way to face your fear is that you must know the God that you serve. There's a song I was listening to during the week. It said, I know the master of the wind and the master of the storm. That word there, no. Psalm 46 verse 1 said, our God is our refuge and our strength, a very present help in time of need. Therefore, will I not fear, though the earth be removed And though the mountain be carried into the midst of the sea, though the water therefore roar and be troubled, though the mountain shake with the swelling thereof, I will not be shaken. Let them sit down in a panel and say, how long have you have as an engineer? This is, I want to say to you, see all those jobs that we said, 10 years experience, 4 years experience, don't mind them. Don't mind them. They're just trying to scare you. Package yourself very well. Sit down comfortable as a child of the king. Tell them what you know and leave the rest for God. Many of us that God has changed our situation, we tell you that it is not what you prepare. If you ask Dr. Priya now, that during that interview, it was it what you prepare? No. There's something, but listen to me. Assuming he was just sitting down, you see, this UK, there's nothing, no. It is well, oh. All of us are just following the trade. This £7, none, we will continue. He will have been in that job. Fear, courage is taking steps. Look at your neighbor and look at yourself and say, how many steps have I taken in courage? How many courageous steps have you taken? All because you know God. You know what God has said. Praise God. As I round up, I said, faith is the only answer to fear. I put it, I said, take the dose of faith nugget every day. Thank God we have a faith statement that is flying every time now in church. I said, if you have come here to come and study, you are an international brand. And even if you have not studied here, you are still an international brand. Listen, this place is the highest point of competition. At this place, it is what you know, not who you know. Let me tell you that it is what you know. And you have to leverage on what you know. So I was saying it here, and she said to me, Pastor, I just got home, and that wall hit me again in my bed. And I took my laptop. And as I was applying, I was laughing at myself. Look at this one. They just put 4 years, 4 years experience. You are applying, you're just wasting your time. But something keeps saying, that is why when you come to church, see, church is not a place of meetings, it's a place of inspiration. You don't come to church because I want to see Brother Kenneth's face or because I want to see Fife's face. No, I came here because I am here for inspiration. So when I get home, I have a force that is pushing me that I cannot even explain. As she said, she was just typing. She's applied. And then she submitted and deleted every other information. I said, Pastor, thank God for that message. Now I am working in that same place now, 3 months after or 4 months after, thereabout. What am I saying? Faith is the only substitution for fear. And what the Bible says, simple word, the Bible says, faith comes by hearing. And what? Hearing the word of God. Perfect love, 1 John 4:18 that we read says, perfect love cast out fear. 1 John 4:18 says, perfect love cast out fear. When I was reading that, and let me round up with this, I was thinking there that the Bible was talking of my love for God. But when I read it, I found that he was talking of his love for me. Because when you read down scriptures, you think the Bible says perfect love casts out fear. But let's go back from 1 John 4:14. Let me read to open your eyes. And we have seen and do testify that the Father sent the Son to be the Savior of the world. Watch that. That's 14. Whatsoever shall confess that Jesus is the Son of God, God dwell in him, and he in God. 16. And we know and believe that the Lord that God has to us, God is love, and he that dwelleth in love dwelleth in God, and God in him. Herein in our love made perfect, that we may have boldness in the day of judgment. Because as is he, so we are in this world. Verse 18, the one many of us just take and remove. There is no fear in love. Which love? The love that God has for you. He's not talking about the love that you have for him. Anytime I read that scripture, I always think it was the love I have for God. The love that God has for me, that he gave his son for me. In this love, there is no fear. What is he talking about? If God can give his son for me, there's nothing he cannot give to me. My future is secured in this love that Jesus died on the cross. Rise up on the third day. There is no fear in this love. For this perfect love, agape love, casts out all fear. Because fear has torment in it. And that scripture delivered me. Because God loves me so much. See. Romans 8, that you know very well, said, for I will persuade beyond doubt that neither death, nor angels, nor principalities, nor things impending, nor threatening, nor the things come, nor power, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God which is in Christ. Most of the time when we read that scripture, we always think it's about our own commitment to it. But God is saying nothing can separate. God is in total love with me. That enough is for fear to just jump out and run away. That's, I now know why the Bible says, it's a perfect love. Cast away fear. God loves us. He loves you. And he loves me. So I don't know what you're afraid of tonight. Are you afraid of the future? Are you afraid of what is going to happen to me when I leave the UK? Listen, nothing is going to happen to you. Do you know why? Because you are God's apple's eyes. God jealously will guide your future. The only thing you need to do is to stay in his court, stay in his path. Don't allow fear to hold you down. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I want to say to you this morning, I want you to rest in his love. Rest in his love. Rest in his love. Church, can we rise up on our feet, please? Like I said when we started, fear is a spirit. And what fear will do for you is to stop you from fulfilling your destiny. Amen to Jesus. I just want you to pray one prayer before I invite mommy to the front. I want you to pray for yourself. I want you to look at one thing in your life that you are afraid of. Now. One thing in your life that you are afraid of. Mommy, ma, please. I want you to look at one thing in your life that you are afraid of. And I want you to pray. Father, as your son has preached this morning, God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of love and of sound mind.